back with Membership Mondays. We're down at the beach at Tidelands Community Hospice, which is so awesome because this is their newest location, their second location. And we have Marketing Director Seth Blackwell with us, and he's going to kind of tell us what Tidelands does.
Okay. Well, thank you for having us today. Yeah. First and foremost, I just want to talk about hospice care. It is about a focus of long-term comfort care. Mm-hmm. It is mainly an emphasis of quality of life versus the quantity of life. And, you know, Tidelands Hospice basically was founded on an idea and a desire to help people in the community with terminal illnesses. We got started back in 1981. Some ladies at Prince George Winyall Episcopal Church got together and wanted to help people in the community. Mm-hmm. And they rounded up a committee of about 25 people to go out and recruit neighbors, friends, church members, civic organizations, and businesses. And during this recruitment, it's all about working together to educate what hospice care was about and helping raising money to also make us have licensure to be able to provide care in the area. And in March of 85, we were able to obtain licensure, and we became one of the first not-for-profit hospices in South Carolina. And we admitted our first patient in April of 1985 under the name of Hospice of Georgetown County. Mm-hmm. And we have carried that name for 17 years. And we continue to grow, caring for people in Georgetown, Orion, Williamsburg counties. In 2002, to better reflect the communities we served, we changed our name to Tidelands Community Hospice, which we are present day. And it's amazing that with the care that we provided, it got started with neighbors helping neighbors, to make Tidelands Community Hospice into being what we are and to make us strong in caring for people in the area.
That's awesome. And big step, big changes that you guys have done since the beginning, so that's great. And so I was speaking, you know, before the video, we were talking about how you have traveling patients and hospice isn't just bedridden. Kind of touch on that a little bit, how you care for these traveling patients.
Sure. Basically, most people, the perception they have about our plan of care is they feel like that it's completely end of life, and that is not the case. You know, Medicare's made a lot of changes to where people can receive this benefit much sooner, mm-hmm. and we take care of people wherever they call their home,
right.
Whether it is their actual home, if it's an assisted living, if it's a nursing facility, even in the hospital, and sometimes at inpatient facilities. And we also take care of people who do travel. We have a lot of people that come down here for, you know, if they want to have a little weekend from out of states, and we care for them while they're here until they go back home. So it's really has grown. It's made it the benefit much beneficial, but it's made it to where people can really focus more on what's important for them.
Yeah.
For as their days are maybe coming closer towards the end, and we're about being side by side with them throughout this process. It's about making sure that we meet every need for them, providing the best care each and every day, and making sure that we honor their wishes throughout their journey with us.
Yes, and that's important. You want to make sure they're comfortable and they're living out, you know, their last days as best as they would like to.
Correct.
So you mentioned that you have some events on your website.
Yes.
And what is that website that they can check those out at?
Our website is at www.tidelandshospice.org, and you can definitely go check it out, where we do a lot of fundraising events with us being a nonprofit. Coming up May 1st, we have Palmetto Giving Day. That's for nonprofits in the area, and we're having ours at the Hammock Shop in Pawleys Island, so definitely come out and check that out. But we also have Relate for Life that's coming up here in Myrtle Beach. We have our annual golf tournament that's in I think the end of July, and that's at Pawleys Plantation.
Okay.
We also have the seafood festival we do at the Hanser House in Litchfield. Heath Hanser and his family have been very good as far as wanting to give back and help with Tidelands Hospice and help with the community. So there's plenty of events that we do, and definitely go check them out. Plus, you can always donate to us as well. If you have a loved one that has passed, or anyone that you know that could benefit from having help, always donate to us.
Well, awesome. And like you said, check out the website. You have volunteer opportunities on there as well.
Absolutely. That's one of our proponents as far as having with our care is having volunteers. And they can be a great companion for patients and for families, because we understand that families are the main caregivers, and they're given 100%. of their care to their loved one, but at the same time, they can get mentally and physically burned out. So it's great to know that you do have that avenue of having a volunteer that can come in and be that companion, whether it's, you know, have conversation with them, if it's, you know, play games, if it's, you know, just watching TV, reading a book, those types of things. So volunteers are very, very important in our plan of care.
Oh, yeah, and we use volunteers ourselves, and we know how much they mean to us and how much they help us out. So check out their website, tidelandscommunityhospice.org, and see the events they have coming up, the volunteer opportunities, and see what you can do to help out Tidelands and their hospice patients and just give back to the community. Thank you, Seth, for letting us come out and speak with you.
Thank you, Harley, for having us.
We look forward to some of the events coming up.
All right. Thank you.